humming, hear the boom bags humming, Newtown, Newtown, Newtown is flying, there'll be no denying, Newtown, Newtown, 13 men all dressed in blue, look out cause they're coming through Newtown.
The Jets, let's get straight into this one. Noddy, Sam Williams for Mounties has been in and out of first grade this year, so he brings leadership and experience to this side.
He certainly does. You know, he's played 130 first grade games because he's played in the NRL and in the Super League. So that experience is certainly going to be very important for you. I thought the Mounties really struggled last week with their completion rate and that hurt them, the possession of ball they had. So what does Sam Williams does? Well, Sam Williams brings back game control, kicking game. Obviously, he's the general halfback out there and he'll steer him around. So I think he's a very important player for the Mounties group.
Spud, you've been looking at former Newcastle Knight Tom Starling. Why is he someone that needs to stand up today?
Well, I think in this sort of a conditions, he has a forward that can lay some massive platforms, and he's dummy half work. He's made 140 runs, 45 runs from dummy half, which is quite exciting. Yeah.
All right, let's get over to Jimmy Smith now, who's standing by with Mounties coach Peter Maripodi.
Well, Pete, a couple of changes. They come late. How does that impact on the team? How does that impact on you?
Well, it's the level we're at with reserve grade, and we understand that. We've signed on for that, so we're here to support first grade in a way. But, you know, that hasn't even really been mentioned this week for our team. We've got a team good enough to win today, and that's the way we approach it.
Bit of an up-and-down season. Your best has been very good. Has that been a little bit of a frustration for you?
It has been. You hope you can deal with adversity better than what we have. But in saying that, we've been able to gather ourselves and build some momentum coming into the finals.
One thing that Newtown have is momentum. How do you impact on that today? What do you see as the threats from Newtown?
Well, they've got a big forward pack that we need to match early, but they're also a team that shifts the ball really quickly. So Kennedy at the back on his big sweep line's a big threat for us. They've got a bit of momentum coming in, but that's where we've got to play some positive footy and go after them.
Good luck today, Pete.
Thanks, mate.
Well, Peter Maripodi, speaking there about the impact Will Kennedy is going to have for the Jets, Noddy, you agree?
Yeah, I can't wait to watch him play. Obviously, extremely fast. You know, returns the ball at some pace. Two tries last week, 7 line breaks. So I think he's a big key for the Newtown side. He's electric if he gets the ball out the back.
A couple of team changes for both sides. So Blayke Brailey comes into the side, which then pushes Scott Sorensen back to the back row. But you like the look of him.
I love the look of him. He's named number 9, plays number 11 all the time. 200 metres last week, 18 tackles. I call him the full package. He gives 100% every week.
Let's catch up with the Jets coach now. Jimmy is with Greg Madison.
Well, Greg, one thing you must be really happy with is the form of the side going into the semi-finals. Is that right?
We've been up and down. We haven't put 80 minutes together yet. We've had some good halves, but, you know, today, semi-final, we need an 80-minute performance.
One of the guys who's been key coming in late after that knee injury has been Toby Rudolph. What does he bring to the side?
Yeah, he's a bit of a character, Toby. He gets the boys up and live. He's a bit lively bloke, but he's got good energy out there. He's aggressive. So, yeah, he's brought something to the table for us.
Mounties clearly a strong club, and they're going to be a danger today. Where does you see their major points of attack and defence?
Oh, you know, as you said, they're a strong club, but their four little men are a worry for me, like Starling, Williams, Ingarno and O'Hagan. You know, we need to shut them down. If we give them too much go forward in the middle and let them play off the back of that, we'll be in trouble.
Good luck today, Matto.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Coming up next on Fox League, it's kickoff in our next elimination final. See you soon.
Well, part of the crowd here for the elimination final, the second one today at Campbelltown Stadium. We have Mounties up against the Newtown Jets after Wentworthville. A little bit earlier, put the fifth place Penrith Panthers out of the competition. Let's have a look at this Mounties side as they line up today. A number of changes, and it is Adahingana who's going to be at the back. That is a big inclusion for them as well. No Emre Gula, no Michael Oldfield, no Sebastian Chris, but there's some experience there. Sam Williams at half, Jack Murchie and Luke Bateman at the back of the scrum as well provide a lot of experience. I mentioned Sammy Williams a little bit earlier. I caught up with him.
Well, Semi, deeply experienced at NRL level, does it go up a cog when you get to semi-final time?
Yeah, it is, Jimmy. It's really exciting. I know all the players play. You know, you got a long, arduous season to get to this point. So they're really excited in there. As you said, it goes up a notch now. It's the little things we've been speaking about all year. You've really got to bring it today and make sure it happens. Otherwise, we'll be out round one of the competition.
What about the weather conditions today? Really strong wind. You're obviously important with your kicking game. Have you looked at that, thought about what you might be doing?
Yeah, if you're going into that breeze, it can be hard to make too much distance. Sometimes you've got to keep it low. So if I can try and find a little bit of grass, it's going to give us a chance. But both teams have to play with it. So it's important we hold on to that footy and give ourselves a chance to play a bit of field position.
Opposition's playing well. Where's the threat come mostly from Newtown?
Yeah, they're a good side. They move the ball really well. They fall into shape really well. So we've got to make sure we can match them. We've conceded a few tries early, which have been disappointing the last few weeks. So we've got to make sure we're on defensively and we're aggressive and go and get them.
Good luck today, Semi.
Thanks, mate.
Well, if it is the Bounty side losing players, Newtown Jets get a couple of really good ones. Blayke Brailey is into the team in jersey number 26, and Jayson Bukuya is in jersey number 14. He'll be at the back of the scrum, 183 NRL games. And of course, he's played 11 tests for Fiji as well. Williams on Williams, just about in the halves. Let's have a hear from the Newtown Jets' Jack, who I caught up with a little bit earlier.
Well, Jack, one thing about the side, scoring plenty of points and in good form, that must give you confidence for this game.
Yeah, we've been able to score a fair few points. It's just holding on to the ball for us that we need to focus on. We got points in us out wide with our talented backs that we got, but yeah, we just got to hold on to the ball and it should be right.
Do you assume that senior role in the absence of Kyle Flanagan? Does that suit your game?
Yeah, me and Tricky played pretty much all year together, so we handle it. Each other has majority of the ball game, if you know what I mean. So, yeah, I think it'll be sweet.
What about the conditions? Really windy for you? That kicking game's going to be impacted by that. What are your thoughts going into the game?
Yeah, been watching a bit of the game just before and there's a few kicks gone dead, so going into the wind it'll be a bit tougher. With the wind it'll be even tougher, so just got to watch how much weight we put on it. So,
good luck today, Jack.
Thanks.
He's a very good young player, isn't he? Looking forward to seeing him in action today, Jack Williams. Mark Spud Carroll here in commentary with me. There's one of your favourites, Jamin Jolliffe.
He certainly is. Been working on him the last few weeks, Jimmy, as you know, and he's the main meat eater for the Newtown Jets. Already 327 hit-ups this year.
Yeah, it's not only the amount of work, he gets through big minutes as well. Highly effective in what he does. Mounties side now out onto the field. They'll have the benefit of this huge breeze in the first half, and your big man up front, Royce Hunt, is going to be a key today, Spud.
Yeah, I love picking out the front rolls. There's another big unit. Royce Hunt, he's given a great opportunity to start the game, Jimmy. Usually comes off the bench. Very strong defender. Loves the action through the middle, so can't wait to see what he can do.
We've watched him a couple of times this year. Haven't been impressed with what he's done. It's all power.
Yeah,
a
little bit.
So the challenge there for Pete Maripodi, how long does he leave Royce Hunt out there? What sort of work can he get through? Here we are, underway. Elimination final, week one. Royce Hunt does well to pick it up. Difficult bounce and charges back into this Newtown side. Lolo's there to greet him. There's Bailey in jersey 26. Now Tony Sattini. Strong carry from him. We'll expect that throughout the course of the game. It's been a feature of his play this year. This is Vincent Rennie's come into the side. Older brother of Ruben. Ruben in the centres. Bateman cuts across the back. He's one of those guys that, despite all his experience at NRL level, hasn't been able to play a game there this year. It's Ngano. He's a big inclusion today. Great skill at the back, recovering from that shoulder injury. Here's the opposition fullback. Interesting that he was singled out by Mounties team. Spud is a real danger man today.
Well, he certainly is. He's got some amazing skill from the back. You've got to get it up in his face straight away.
So despite the wind, it is nice and warm here today. It's a very fast track. We saw some good attacking footy in the earlier elimination final. Here's Jolliffe. Oh, nice charge. The ball was there for Williams decided not to throw it. Jayson Bukuya makes his way over halfway. Last tackle now. They'll go Williams on the left-hand side. Straight away they shift the footy. Now he's putting it under the hands of their man. Coming back through the centre. That looks like Harley Smith Shield. Looking forward to seeing him play. His numbers coming out of Jersey Flegg are fantastic. Let's get a complete conditions update down with Hannah Hollis.
Thank you, Jimmy. Sunshine and blue skies at Campbelltown Sports Stadium, but gale force winds at the backs of the Mounties. If you have just joined us on Fox League this afternoon, we had an earlier elimination final and we saw a couple of seven tackle sets as the teams adjusted to this strong breeze. Both Mounties and Jets, though, they were in the stands watching most of that earlier game, so they know what they're in for.
There's a kick from Sammy Williams, who kept it low with that strong breeze behind him. Tyrone Phillips got back there quickly. But you can see the impact it's having, Spud, about exactly what the kick options are for the halves for both sides, given this breeze.
Yeah, we interviewed the halfbacks at the start of the game, mate. It's all about the kicking game and the depth of the kick.
Aaron Gray, 40 minutes from him last week just to test that knee. He'd been out for 6 weeks. Just a bit of a clean-up. And he's hopeful of pushing out 80 today. I know his coach, Greg Madison, would love that. Such a powerful runner. Speaking of, Jolliffe goes forward again. Last tackle now for Newtown. Comes now to Trindall. That's a great kick into the breeze. Great kick into the breeze. 40-20, superb there from Braydon Trindall.
Into the wind.
Well, we know he's a point scorer, he's a goal kicker, he's a real organiser of this side, but as you say, to kick a 40-20 today into the breeze, unheard of. Gee, it's a big play. Here they go, Newtown. Great attacking opportunity for them. Lolo's on the right. Brailey, dummy, then gave it to him. The big Wes stands in the tackle, thought about the offload. Brailey, long to Williams, double pumps out the back. Sorensen with the offload and Phillips will score. Well, your man Sorensen, you call him the full package. He's delivered the pass and Newtown get the first try.
It's quite incredible. He's got number 9 on his back. He plays on the outside forwards there, but this all comes down from the 40-20, end of the wind, Jimmy. And then we'll see some outstanding out passing to score on the corner there. It's always a game changer. We can do a 40-20, and we've certainly seen that.
Just looking at the defensive read, Matthew Tomoko, he went on in on that lead runner. You could see there he was upset with himself. He knew it was a defensive lapse. You give Scott Sorensen that opportunity, and he just takes it. Tyrone Phillips with the try. 15 NRL games in his career, test matches for Fiji. He's come up with the first try of this elimination final. I think if there's a side in the bottom four of the eight that could really do some damage going deep into this final series, I think it's Newtown.
No, I've got to agree with you, Jimmy. We've seen him at Newtown over the other day. It was just outstanding what they can do on the field. They've got a great back line, but they've also got some great forwards who lay some platforms, but it's all about the bench. I just think that if they get deep in this competition, they can give it a nudge.
Braydon Trindall. 142 points for the year, 55 goals, 76%. This is as tough as it gets. Let's see how he hasn't quite allowed enough for the breeze, and it's misses just in difficult conditions. We understand that, but what about that 40-20 to start things, Hannah?
Oh, it was incredible. And actually, in the earlier elimination final as well, we saw another 40-20 in the first 5 minutes of the game. Let's talk about tomorrow, Jimmy. The Sunday ticket. It all comes down to the last round on the last day of the regular season to determine who gets to claim eighth spot. At a sold-out Leichhardt Oval, it's the Tigers and the Sharks. Will the fairy tale continue for Robbie Farah or Paul Gallen? It is exclusive on Fox League. And after that blockbuster, we have our final game of the regular season between the Panthers and the Knights.
Well, you're quite right, Hannah. Could they script it any better? Exclusively live on Fox League.
Sam, all the way back, Sam.
Tigers and the Sharkies at Leichhardt.
You ever played there, Jimmy?
Played a lot of games at Leichhardt. Love playing there.
It's a great, even just to be a spectator, just to get there's a ground is absolutely brilliant.
Proximity of the crowd, exactly. Mm. There'll be 18,000 plus there tomorrow.
Hot doggies out in the front. Hot doggies. He'll be out there.
It's Bukuya with a run, tackled in the middle of halfway. Spud salivating. Jolliffe with another carry.
That's his second carry this set.
Trindall. Kicking game's been superb. Smith Shields get back and picks it off. As I said, I'm really interested to see Harley in action today. Younger of three brothers, he's a power runner. Can play a bit of fullback if required. Only a couple of games up at Canterbury Cup level. Jersey flag aged, but has shown himself to be a player of real promise.
Coming forward on three.
There we go. Tony Sertini just walking off the mark there, so everything slows down a little for that.
Last year, question, Jimmy, why have we got two referees today? Why has it changed because of semi-finals? We've been commenting how good it's been one referee. There's two.
You know why it's changed? Because of semi-finals.
Yeah, but I think these other guys have been done a magnificent job one-on-one.
Well, here's Phillips with another run, and that's first try scorer. Good contact coming in there. It's Vincent Rennie. The run from Sorensen. As you say, listed to be the dummy half, has played there previously in Jersey Flex, so Coach Madison's got no concerns about that. But equally effective out on that left edge. Brailey is there at dummy half. This is Talakai now. Gets those legs pumping. Last tackle, and Trindall comes across to the right-hand side here, and that's where Brailey will find him to thread it back through the middle. Can't do that. Off legs, and away goes Ngano, looking for a runner on the outside. Oh, one-on-one strip. Talakai, I think, has come up with a knock-on.
Yes.
Let's hear from referee Ultram.
Into a knock-on, it's a Mounties feed.
Now, you threw me a little there, Spud, with the second referee, and what we have is we've got in goal judges, adjudicators, referees. So there's still the one referee, that's Drew Ultram. We've got the two sideline officials. And we've got the two men in the in goal area.
I've never seen so many referees on one pitch. I feel like I was watching an AFL game. That's amazing to watch live, how many guys are out there doing that game. But I just hope the main guy does the main calling. As we've said, we've given them a massive rap this year. I just think they've been outstanding.
Just to let you know, Spud, you're watching Canterbury Cup New South Wales Elimination Final at Campbelltown Stadium. He's that power we spoke of. Plenty of post-contact meters there from Royce. Starling, Ngano out. Now O'Hagan went short. This is Murchie. Can't get the arms through. Nice defensive work there from Gray. Starling, a thought knock on. Play on is the call. Crowd are of the same opinion, I think. They go back on the inside now to Rennie. So Mounties putting pressure now on Newtown. Nice hands from Williams. Out the back from Ngano. So all the halves involved there. Player in front. Just not quite getting their structure right there.
Yeah, there's contact in the line here. Mark's here, thanks, mate.
That's Matthew Tomiko, who is not so happy with the call of the referee. We'll have to go back and check it out on the replay, but penalty goes the way of Newtown.
I think it all comes down to decoy running. Jimmy didn't run through the line, as they said, otherwise known as a shepherd, or taking the player out. The decoy was fine. He just had to keep running through the line, not stop.
Oi, spot the hooker.
So the really only the good opportunity, the best opportunity that Mounties have had in this half, and just didn't quite get it right.
I
Williams finds Lolo. Yeah, a bit wider. Trying to get himself at Hingano, and he did that. Murchie there to assist. Brailey holding it up. Now Talakai. Mascot Jets Jr. Some NRL experience with the South Sydney Rabbitohs a couple of years ago. Trindall right across field. Williams on Williams. He tried to shut him down. Sam on Jack. Jack did well to get away. I think Sam Williams realised they had numbers on the outside. Beautifully held up there. Brailey to Bukuya. Now it's the last for Newtown. They go back to Williams on the left. That was Ferris. Lovely kick. He's got to pull it up. He can't do it. The breeze is strong. It's not strong enough for him. And it'll be a seven tackle set starting on the 20-metre line for Mounties.
That was a really good set of six by the Newtown side. Unfortunately, finished off with a seven tackle set. But the go-forward's been brewing up the middle. As I said, Jolliffe's now already done six carries. His goal today is 20. Let's see if he can hit the mark.
Who set him that goal, Mark?
Me. I love setting goals to these kids. I've got a couple of players I've been doing every side now. Jimmy doing this Canterbury Cup, New South Wales Cup. And I just think I can see improvement in these players. And their goal is to play first grade, so this is where they've got to start.
Brendan O'Hagan. He's taking on the line. Starling to dummy half. Lovely long pass to Williams. Here's Hunt again. So similar ideas to what Newtown have been doing. Just getting those big front rowers running a bit wider. Ingano to Moko. Ball comes free. That will be play on. Ball went back, says referee Ultram, so it's not six more. Now he's saying last. Slow play the ball, Ingano. Goes to Williams. Just a little chip into the corner. Kennedy flies high, does nicely.
What's your take on this win, Jimmy, regards? What do you reckon it's worth? You know, they talk about points. Do you think it's worth points for the Mounties to be up ahead by a few?
Well, it was interesting in the earlier game where Wente 34 beat Penrith 16. The majority of the points were scored into the breeze.
Amazing.
So it might tell you something of the mindset. Oh, that looked flat, in fact, forward.
Good pick up.
Call from the sideline official. Lolo was getting pushed backwards in some strong defence. And the one-handed offload that looked fantastic, unfortunately, went forward. Ooh.
So good eyes.
Significantly forward, I would have thought. So they mucked up their script last time they were down here. Let's see how Mounties go this time around.
You've got a hole with your lock here.
That was their first mistake for the game.
Head in.
Ooh, look at this. Scrum formed 25 metres out, 25 metres in from this Western touchline, and every single Mounties player is over on the right-hand side. Stubby from Williams. O'Hagan created the extra man on the outside, didn't release. It's Vincent Rennie. Been playing a bit of footy at Newcastle Thunder the last couple of years. He's come back to play with his brother. Mounties full of running. Ingano, lovely pass and the release. This is a try first up. It's nice work, Harley Smith Shield. But beautiful passing through the middle by Mounties. And they've got their first try of the day.
Yeah, it all comes from a mistake, Jimmy. We speak about this every week. You can't make mistakes. There was a forward pass back. The linesman called it, but the outside backs, everyone's doing their job. Great decoy running, great shift of hands. Magnificent passing in windy conditions, but I put it all down to the decoys. Taking their player out, which allows extra man out wide. And a great comeback by the Mounties.
Well, the pass from Ada Hingano was superb. It looked for all money like it was going to Brendan O'Hagan. Hits Reuben Rennie, who immediately offloads to Harley Smith Shields, and they get the try. There he is, fourth try in seven games. I told you about his jersey fleek numbers. He's averaging 110 metres at Canterbury Cup level. Wow. He's 160 metres a game, jersey fleek level. He's Sammy Williams. Cooma Colt Jr. Olsen Gregory's College Campbelltown boy.
But another pet hate here, Jimmy. You know, every ground we go to, I'm looking for the posts, I'm looking for the flag. Guess what? No flags. Windy conditions. Where's he going to aim? Right post.
At least. At least. He's aimed it right at that. Sam Williams has hit and got it away. So he improves on his 69% success rate in 2019. Is our try scorer, Harley Smith-Shields. Tell you what, he's Jersey Fleeg age. If I looked like that spud, I'd burn every T-shirt I own.
Mate, he's in great nick, the kid, isn't he? He's just, you can see he just loves his footy. I love watching these young blokes. They just love playing rugby league. They want to get out here and play their best.
Well, Satini, his ball was getting away from him. Here's Hunt, and that is strong defence. Four in there. Bukuya leading the way, Jolliffe as well. Vincent Rennie. They've got numbers here. Hingano's got Murchie on the outside and just straightened up off the left, Murchie, but he did have numbers on the outside. Starling's recognised that. Hingano as well. Short ball, Rennie. This is strong ball carrying. There's no one in front of him. Kennedy's missed it cold. Flings it over the top to Harley Smith Shields and he gets another one. Just like that. They had them for numbers all the time down their short side, and they stripped them a couple of times and got the try.
It's great vision. By the number nine, Tom Starling. We spoke about him at the start of the game. He's had 145 runs from dummy half, squirted down the blind side, numbers up, and just great ball handling to score back-to-back tries against the Newtown Jets. Not even a no-look pass. I love that when kids do that.
What about that pass from Rennie? He's had the two try assists. The first one was very straightforward. That one, not so. Ngannou again with the key pass. A couple of missed tackles there.
Yep.
That won't please Coach Madison. And Mounties. You almost need to see the play leading up to that because they had them for numbers on that occasion as well. Just wanted to check that put down. Looked okay to you, Spud.
They love putting the ball down like that. One hand is a love. As I got told as a kid, put it down with two hands, not one. But these kids have got so much confidence. But I just think these you can see the creams rise to the top coming to the semi-final period. They're so well drilled, these sides, the Mounties. Any attacking opportunity, decoy runners at the plenty. Great to watch.
Williams has kept it low. It's low. It's very low. It's over. The worm burner gets there.
What a great kick.
Just as we were talking about Newtown as the threat to the sides in the top four, out of nowhere come Mounties, reminding everyone just what a danger they can be. Got to keep stressing it. They are the beneficiaries of a very strong breeze here at Campbelltown Sports Stadium in this first half.
Since I brought that up with you, Jimmy, they've actually scored 12 points. So maybe they might be thinking, geez, we have to probably have 20 up before we have to turn the corner at halftime.
What number did you put?
I think in my head I had 20. I think it's a gusting breeze.
Here's the kickoff from Trindall. Tell you what, it's a good strike into the breeze, and this is that's a great carry.
Good run.
Who'd you have a chat with?
I always go both front rolls. Yeah, I went down and seen Royce Hunt. And I told him, mate, I want him to run from the back fence and try and get 20 metres every kickoff. And, mate, he did everything to the letter there. It was brilliant.
Bateman. Starling out of dummy half. Here they go, working down this short side. Talakai's gone too high. Just want to check he's okay out of Hingano. Looked a little bit nasty. Penalty sufficient there. The referee, Ultram. Let's have a look at it again.
It was high, but wasn't on his head, it was around the neck area.
Ngano's up, ready to go again. Murchie now with a carry. He's proving a handful, isn't he? Ngano. Now Rennie, think about an offload, doesn't. defenders there. They're being stretched again. Mounties on the attack. Williams goes to the outside. O'Hagan is looking for the runner. Tomoko is going to be able to stop, and he's got it down. You saw the nod from the in-goal judge. Point to the spot. Bang, 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 go the Mounties.
What a great try. Just looking at the, mate, you can just see the class. As I said, Jimmy, the regards, you know, Sam Williams, he's deft to hands, he's cut out passes. His vision out wide to get out wide. Last we see another try.
Let's have a look at it. This is Matty Tomoko. Probably a little disappointed with himself for the defensive read for the first try for Newtown, but this is just a show of strength, determination as well. Had Satini on the outside, decided not to use him, but you're right, the long passing. Williams to O'Hagan, players in space. Just his fourth game up. Matt Tomoko, another one of these guys who's Jersey Flegg age. In fact, he's got another year in Jersey Flegg. So you can see what sort of talent he is.
As you know, Jimmy, a real good halfback. Can go to the line, also catch and pass. This time he actually went to the line, dragged the defence in, Sam Williams, with a nice deft pass out wide. But I tell you, he had a lot to do, that kid, to score that try. Actually, brilliant.
Well, he just, Jackson Ferris got a little bit interested, had to make that move from the outside defensively, and he just couldn't quite make up his yard. Here's Sammy Williams. He's persisting with the flat ones. Oh, waved away on this occasion. But they're making best use of this breeze, Hannah.
They sure are. I want to talk about the matchup of these two teams. Very similar on paper. Yes, it's 6-7, but only points differential actually separate these two sides. This season, they have won 11 games, both sides. They have lost 10 games, and they've had one draw. Really interesting, but the Mounties taking advantage of the win. They let a couple of early opportunities go missing. That's not the case anymore.
Pretty much in control at the moment, Hannah, aren't they? Here's Hunt again, and look at the explosion when he gets to the defensive line. They've already met a couple of times this year, way back in round two, and it was Mounties winning. We called this game down at Shark Park, and then in round 14, it was the Jets having a win away against Mounties. So they're one apiece. O'Hagan. Ngarno skipped to the outside. Murchie is there. This is now Smith's shield. Won't stay away from the sideline. A little bit of inexperience there. Your man Sione Katoa does the defensive work.
They really need to drop under play there, Jimmy. Just kept running the same angle. It's always going to go on the outside. But a nice tackle by Katoa. I just think, what about that try he scored last week? That was one of the best finishing tries I've seen from a winger. Outstanding.
Absolutely brilliant, wasn't it? Oh. Last time we saw him play, that was at Henson Park. Jets had a big win over the Magpies on that occasion. And he, well, if he doesn't win try of the year, then we've missed a couple of spectacular ones. This is Rudolph on the field now.
It's another favourite player of mine, Jimmy. I love this guy. I think he's so much Jeff Robbins alike. Look at his hair.
He's only a couple of games back from an ACL that he suffered playing for Redcliffe in the state championship match last year. He'd signed on the Saturday with the Sharks. Suffered the ACL injury on the Sunday. So rotten luck for the Southeastern Seagulls junior. But you're right, makes a difference to this side. That'll help too. Bakuya's taken the quick tap. There's the experience of him. And pushes away from tackles as well. They need to steady the ship here in Newtown. Points is a bonus. Brailey throws to Williams, goes to the outside. Here's Trindall, and again, Kennedy releases. Katoa will fly and get it down. No flag up from the sideline official. Point to the spot, Drew Altram, and tell us he scored another miraculous try.
There's a loud speaker outside. He must have heard what I was saying. What a great put down. You try and do that as a winger flat out, but I just think they had to be the next scorer. Up against all odds, but the inclusion here, great ball running there, hole running, angle runs, nice pass. Look at this put down. Incredible.
Oh, yeah.
I think we said last time, I hope there's a cameraman. There was one there last week. There's got to be one there right now. Look at this.
Of course there is. Look at that, Fox League. You don't miss a thing.
How good is
that? Are we okay with the put down?
100%.
It's too late now. Let's see it again.
Mate,
no problem.
That should be on every highlight reel when we're trying to sell the game to these kids and say, come and have a bit of fun. How these guys contort outside the line now. I know they've taken out the corner flag, which is the best thing I reckon they've ever taken out now. But some of these guys, they've got to practice, surely, the way they land. They don't care.
Sione Katoa was doing that dive for the corner about 10 metres out, I reckon. Chester Hill Hornets Jr. We love watching him play. One of our favourites here at Fox League. Here's the kick from Trindall. Doesn't quite get it right. Nice strike, though. Unfortunately, off direction. But it's exactly what they needed there. Mounties had scored three straight tries. Newtown, first opportunity that they had down there. They get themselves a try. Let's have a look at it again, Spudley. Slowing it down.
Oh. Speed up a little bit.
At full speed, that's a try.
It's a great try. It just shows how good our cameras are.
Well, you asked for the camera to be there. Of course it was.
Come on, big boy, run hard.
There he goes, Toby Rudolph. I don't think he needs the invitation for that. Charges into them.
I asked the guys how he is. He goes, mate, he's mad. So I love that. Now we're running with a bit more intent.
Stevie DeVita's on the field too in jersey number 22.
He's good now, good now.
So now we've had a couple of really good runs. Vasquez gets an opportunity. Bukuya to Trindall. Here's Talakai pushing away from one, pushing away from two. Just about the third. You make it three. There you go. Lovely run. Full of power. Last tackle. Trindall goes high.
That's it.
Catch that one. Smith Shields under it. Oh, brilliant. Fingertip control. Had the distraction of Williams flying through. I was able to hang on to it. Nice work there from Harley. Let's have a look at that replay. Wow. That is great control. Second time Tony Sertini's walked off the mark here today. That wind is strong.
You're saying the wind's pushing him over?
That's it. 15 line breaks this year for Tony Sertini. Equal third in the competition. 13 tries. Equal third in the competition.
Jack, all the way, Jack.
So he's had a really good year out on that right wing. Here's Murchie. Straightened up on Bukuya. Bukuya looked like he was going for the one-on-one. Oh, penalty. This is exactly what Mounties were looking for.
Mark there, Brendan. Brendan, you're kicking. You're on the mark.
Just getting clarification. Distance wouldn't have been a problem with this strong breeze behind them. You were thinking about taking two. Rennie taps. Williams. He's got Tavita going forward. Yeah, the replacement player's on, Daniel Keir.
All the way, Jack.
So Williams and Sam just behind them play the ball. He went to the right-hand side. They come left-hand side. Hingano releases to Murchie. There's another no-look pass. Good defensive work there from Newtown. Starling seemed to be wrong-footing himself on that occasion. And Gray's able to come up with another really good defensive effort. Ngannou, kick out. Oh, he's caught it. He's dropped it. Harley Smith Shields nearly had try number three. Heard from the referee. Knock on in goal. So this will be a seven tackle set here for Newtown.
That only came off. That was great vision, wasn't it?
Well, the vision from Ngannou. Oh. You see the run there from Ferris. We know he's a powerhouse. Very nearly fingertip control. He almost seemed to have it there. Harley Smith Shields just popped out of the hands. So Newtown have done well to drag themselves this far upfield. Vasquez pushing away from defenders there. It was Hingano that was on the deck for Mounties. Brailey, ball on the inside. Bukuya, and a release. Williams, double pump. Off the hands of Kennedy. That's going to be play on. Sorensen's got speed and power. Straightens up. Rudolph is there. Footwork, stepping. Nearly spins his way to the line. He's over. Better than nearly he got there.
What a great run.
Spectacular team try for Newtown. And Toby Rudolph, the replacement player, is as happy as Larry.
You're talking about an ACL. What's he stepping here? It's quite incredible. Left and right, right step. But the manoeuvre of the body around at the end. But it's a great lead-up play by Sorensen. His inside ball was brilliant. Look at this ball play. Numbers were on. Trailing through the middle. Rudolph hitting at pace. Left, right, and then had to turn here. One arm put down. Try time.
Oh, gets it on the line. Ball didn't hit the ground either. It's all legal. Referee Ultram right there. This is Sorensen. This is key too. Dummies, gets through, stands, then straightens up. And you're right, wow. The footwork of Toby Rudolph. He went up there to Redcliffe to get an opportunity. Loves the Dolphins. They had such a successful year last year. And it was just disappointing for him what happened in that state championship match. Kick no problem there for Trindall. Into the breeze. And they are now 2 points down.
Regards this Toby Rudolph, mate, seriously, there's an opportunity now at the Sharks. Gallen's moving on. This kid, he can certainly play. I've got high regards for this young bloke. Yeah, as I said, it reminds me so much of Jeff Robbins to our listeners out there. Remember the old days of the Canterbury Bulldogs. But this kid just grabs the ball. Won't seem to get this kick off. He'll run so hard, run between shoulders. He'll get 20 metres for us.
Replacement there. Looks like Luke Bateman coming from the field. More hard to handle this kick off. He does well there, Phillips. Very clever. Sorensen. Sister Marissa is pregnant with her second child. I know that because she's married to Chad Townsend, who's my neighbour. That's right.
A little stat.
If you call it that, yeah. Big game for Chad tomorrow, no doubt. There they go again. Gray, first opportunity he's had, and he's beating tackles as well. Went over the top of Rennie. And gets the penalty for his team as well. Yeah, that game tomorrow exclusively on Fox League. 2 o'clock kickoff. Pre-game, it'll start at 1:30.
Amazing game.
Out there at Leichhardt Oval, your Sunday ticket. Be an absolute beauty.
Who would have thought the last game of the year is going to decide who's going to make the top eight? Quite incredible.
Exclusively live on Fox League. Here's Talakai. Trindall, your man, Rudolph, spinning again. Bit of a habit as goes into the contact. Talking to Coach Madison, he can play him on an edge, he can play him in the middle. He's got some versatility about him too, Toby Rudolph. And they are on the attack. Newtown, Vasquez, dummy. Oh, lovely defensive work. Steve Tavita, wasn't it? Cut him down. Brailey. Scheming. Trindall does something similar, and he is handled by that defensive effort there. Brought down by Jarrett Boland. Brailey again. Williams, little kick off legs. Oh, very nearly picked up by Ferris. He flashed through.
Knocked on short of the line. On four. Had four.
Just getting confirmation here, referee Ultram. He's going to say handover. Tackle four. Here it is. Yes, nice defensive work. Satini there. He had it in his hands, Ferris. But knocked out at the last minute there by Tony Satini. This might be Scott Sorensen. Is it injured in the in-goal area here for Newtown? It is too. we saw him play and he had some ankle concerns last time at Henson Park.
I think he might have got a finger in the eye or something. He's always might have got a poke in the eye, but geez, that tackle needs to be made. There's about to be 4 minutes to go. The coach killer inside the last 5 minutes. If they scored then, the Newtown Jets, they would have gone in full of high spirit. But a great last defending tackle to stop that nice little kick through as well. Run meters, Scott Sorensen, as I said, he's a meter reader. He just loves it. Through the middle, plays for the full 80 minutes.
How are your front rows going with their targets?
I'm happy with the targets. I'm happy with the targets at the moment. Unfortunately, one of them's just come off Jolliffe, but he's had eight carries. 8 carries for 75 metres.
All the way in.
We're very impressed with Royce Hunt and Rennie up front for the...
back to the mark. Don't come forward and take the mark.
So the Mounties certainly lay a great platform, which allows, as you said, Sam Williams to create some magic.
So Mounties with an opportunity. Just over 3.5 before their time. Rudolph involved in that defensive work. Brailey around the legs. Starling. Nice work. And not sure that he was held. He was, said the referee. Play on. Now with the quick play of the ball. Williams decides to go for a scamper. Last tackle, kicking options. They go right side. There's plenty of them. O'Hagan this time goes high. Kennedy waits patiently, takes it pretty comfortably in the end. Hasn't really been able to get into the game with those sweeping runs that we thought, Will Kennedy.
I've got the out of play.
Phillips grabbing across field, eventually straightened. Sorensen with a run, so he's clearly recovered from that poke in the eye. Rudolph now just mucking up his timing there of Jack Williams. Here's Williams. Trindall went short to Talakai. Well, that was where the sweeping run of Kennedy could have played his part. I think they had extra numbers on the outside there. Last tackle, Trindall. It's back across and this could be dangerous here. Satini through the centre of the field. Got away from the defence of Vasquez. And they wanted to play quickly here. Williams.
Sneaky one. We'll back back, we'll trying to get for penalty.
Yeah, Bukuya clearly offside. Play on's the call from the referee. Rennie now. They're very bunched here, Mounties.
Got again. Here we go.
Here's Smith Shields, pushed out of one. Good strength from the youngster. Starling, Williams, inside, and a key. It's the last tackle. Oh, ball in front of Hingano, couldn't hang on to it. Now it's up for Reuben Porter. He's going to be held. Good defensive work there. It was Brailey and Sorensen that shut things down for Newtown.
Yeah, probably not the ideal finish for the Mounties. They're probably looking for another set of six, Jimmy, there, but unfortunately caught in defence. Probably a minute 10 to go. Well done by the Newtown Jets defensively to hold them out.
Strong shot on Ferris there. Gray had the chance to release. Katoa had no one in front of him as Smith Shields came in to do the big hit. Bukuya, it was meant for Gray. Katoa's got it. He just needs a little bit of space and he's away. Handled there by Murchie. They're still looking to play some footy here, even though they're in their own half, which is good from an entertainment point of view. Last tackle. Brailey goes low into this breeze. O'Hagan at the back now. So let's take your pick about who's playing fullback for Mounties at any given minute.
It's one of the great first half of footy. You can see by the forwards, the way they're walking back, they're a little bit buggered. They recoup, get their oranges, kick back in the second half, and look forward to running into the wind.
Siren, Satini, little kick. Vasquez will want to play on. Kennedy will. That's come up with a knock-on. Knock-on there from...
Keir as well. Knock on each way, the call from the referee. But it has been a highly entertaining first half of footy here at Campbelltown. Mounties 16, Newtown 14.
Newtown is coming, hear the boom bags humming, Newtown.
From purple hair to seeing the mayor.
As I was walking down the hill, I looked up and I thought, bloody hell, there's Johnny Trad. Even though the Jets aren't playing, and he's riding laps of Henson Park, raising money for the club to keep the mighty Jets alive, even though the competition has been cancelled. That's what you call community spirit. Thanks so much, John, for your contribution.
Thank you.
Laps with Traddy has been down at Henson Park each week, doing 80 minutes on his trusty penny farthing to help keep the Jets flying.
So get involved, tell everyone about it, and let's help keep the Jets flying, because we need every cent you can donate. So donate today, and God bless you.
There has been camera crews and podcasts, and news articles to boot, with even league greats.
Weird Traddy, you are so weird. On that penny farthing that keeps spinning and spinning and spinning. Keep those wheels rolling, mate. You're bringing the money in for the Jets.
And Jets heroes lending their support.
Every time the Jets get through adversity, this is no different either. We'll be flying high in 2021.
Calling all Jets fans, it's time to support the club, the defending premiers, and make sure that they thrive on next year. Keep it up, Johnny.
With over 400 laps done and only weeks to go, it's time you put your money where your mouth is and help keep the mighty Newtown Jets stay afloat.
Round and round he goes!
Round and round he goes!
People want to know!
People want to know!
Who he is!
Who he is!
And what he's here for!
What he's here for!
So we tell them!
So we tell them!
The heap of laps we're treading!
The heap of laps we're treading!
The mighty, mighty treading!
The mighty, mighty treading!
Information on how to donate is on the Laps with Traddy Facebook page. And let's look to turn our crowd figure into dollars.
$8,972.
Help keep the Jets flying by donating money to the Laps with Traddy. Go the Jets!
Yes!
Plenty of action in this first half elimination final. It is 6-7. Mounties up against Newtown. And there has been action aplenty. A couple of opportunities gone begging, but mostly in what's been pretty difficult windy conditions, as you can see. It has been really good footy, Spud.
Incredible. I've never seen a first half so close, Jimmy. Have a look at this. First half in their own possession, 50% each. We've had a score 16-14 to the Mounties, 51% to the Newtown, 49% to the Mounties. It's quite incredible. It's 15 missed tackles, 16 missed tackles. It's been a highly entertaining game. I can't wait for the second half.
Well, you couldn't split them on the competition ladder, and now you can't split them at half time during the course of this game. Let's have a look at the highlights. The tries that came in the first half and incredibly into the breeze. It was Newtown who got away first.
It was a great try. This was after a 40-20 into the wind. Great try outside backs. Great pass from Sorensen.
After that, it was Mounties who found their rhythm, and this was a beautiful pass from Adahingano.
Decoy running at its best, doing their job on the inside work. This allows number five to score in the corner.
Harley Smith Shields picked up the first for Mounties, and he got the second as well. And again, it was that man, Hingano, with a lovely pass to Rennie.
Great pass. Well, I also think it starts from Tom Starling from dummy half. His vision to go up the short side and double try outside. Great put down, one-handed. Brilliant.
It's Mounties again. They scored three tries very quickly. And young Matthew Tomoko, we've been impressed with his ball carrying today, and to think he's eligible for Jersey Fleet again next year. And then this was the one that we were salivating about.
Well, this was a great put down. We're just talking about how good he can score a try. But for any young kid, you want to have a winger who can score a try. Watch this kid, how he puts the ball down. But this one of my favourites, running through the middle, doing his work through the middle. Toby Rudolph, great pass here by Sorensen. Watch this for a big man to step. Step left foot, right foot, near the post. But this guy's just getting on for an ACL.
Yes.
Incredible.
Has. That is true. Only had a couple of games back as well. Toby Rudolph gets himself the try. And look at that, very popular with the teammates as well. Three for Mounties, three for the Jets. The difference in the goal kicking has been very tough for Braydon Trindall into that breeze. Sammy Williams has kicked the two from three. Coming up, of course, we've got three big clashes on your Super Saturday. Really important one for the race at Campbelltown. Mounties just shading Newtown at this point. All the action of the next 40 minutes coming your way on Fox League. Your Super Saturday continues. That was a try there to Harley Smith Shields. He got a couple in the first half. Here's the second. And that was Sione Katoa. That's Sione Katoa there, not Superman. Although what we've seen over the last couple of weeks, Mark Carroll, you would think otherwise.
That should be his middle name, bringing Super in the middle. He's just been incredible. We've seen two unbelievable tries over the last, we've seen last week, and he's topped it off. We're just saying how good his finishing is. You see why he got a couple of good games there at Cronulla. But if he keeps this sort of performance up, Jimmy, he'll certainly be back there next year.
You reckon he's got NRL written all over him, don't you? Jack Williams leads out this Newtown side. Newtown fans, plenty of them in the crowd here today. I think the King of Portugal is here, Barry Cotter, club president. There's our man, Sione Katoa.
There he is. I just, for any young kid out there, just put your body in line stuff. He doesn't care who's coming across. Arms out. And he contorts himself outside that line every time. I just think it's a bit of a game to his. Maybe he says it to his brother, I bet I can do a better try this weekend. Or he says it to his mates. But as I said, the way they practice is incredible.
Adehangano has been really good today. And, you know, I don't think his stats do him justice. Try assist, yes. But some of the passing that we've seen from him has been key in those try-scoring movements for Mounties.
Yeah, so I love how he inserts himself in the back line, Jimmy. He's much like Slater. You know, Slater was the first ever to do it, but these young kids are now watching these players who did it the best, and you can see it's implementing into their game.
Of course, he's had that shoulder injury, Adehangano. We know what a star he is. Playing for Tonga. Just waiting on a tee here, Brendan O'Hagan. Blayke Brailey. Squeeze brother Jayden out of the Cronulla Sharks.
Isn't this a beautiful old ground? It is really, it's amazing that the condition this ground is, and I can see why the West Tigers come in and have some great games here.
I remember coming down here in the mid-80s. Oh, Aaron Gray. It's a pinball machine. It's bounced off him that hard. Unfortunately, that is not the start. Newtown, well, look, it looks like the boys are making sure everyone gets a high five from Mounties, but that's a disappointment there for Gray. Just came off the shoulder, I think.
Yeah, off his pectoral muscle. I reckon he got a bit of sun in the eyes there. I was waiting for his hand to go up. It was an unusual kick off, keep low, as I said, into this very strong wind, but off the pecs. Not a great start for the Newtown Jets.
Father Brian will be disappointed with that. Legend of country rugby league, Brian Gray. Captain coached the Junie Diesels to the Group 9 Premiership in 1986 with a young Laurie Daly as his 16-year-old 5'8".
I love these stats. Give me another one.
All right. Cooter Bulldogs in 88.
There we go.
Beautiful. Captain coach.
Captain coach.
He was captain coach, yeah.
Wow.
A strong coaching career with the Roosters in the lower grades as well. So Mounties, first opportunity of this second half. Oh, that's very deep for O'Hagan. Back inside to Porter. Three defenders there, including Rudolph. Sorensen still caught up with that one. Long ball to Williams. It's going to go long out the back to Hingano, and it's a lovely pass to O'Hagan. Nicely read by Gray on that occasion. Buddy releases the football. Hingano again releases to Rennie. Oh, no! Stop it! Ball out the back, and Harley Smith Shield says, thank you, I'll have my third. Reuben Rennie take a bow.
Yeah. amazing hands. Unbelievable. All from mistakes, Jimmy. From the kickoff off the pectoral muscles, you've got to aim up the next set of six. But the outside back work here. What about this pass here? It's an underarm pass round through the middle of the score in the corner. It's number three tries for him today.
Reuben Rennie. It was the John Cartwright pass as he's falling to ground. Let's take a look at it. Engage Katoa. Katoa thought, well, I've got to shut this ball down. But before he got the chance to get there, Reuben Rennie has released. Here it is again. Oh, magical.
Amazing skill.
But no look either. Real trust that his man's going to be there.
He knew he was going to be there. But it's just, as I said, we can't make mistakes in this game. But semi-final period, boys, you've got to take kickoffs. And from there, they score a try. I was going to say out loud, I think it might be a game changer. They just can't. That's the first kickoff in the second half. You want to score. You want to score. You know, start the game strong, but unfortunately, the Newtown Jets, not the start they wanted. But
disappointment there for Sammy Williams. Didn't quite get that one, and we know how difficult it is. Let's go down to Hannah and find out what was said at halftime.
Oh, Jimmy, Peter Maripodi was very happy with his team's first 40. He just wants now to see more control of the ball and to take control of the wind, if that's possible. As for Greg Madison, he said he was disappointed with the six tackle kicks. He said there wasn't enough pressure being applied on the kicker, so the plan now is to attack their edges in numbers and watch the discipline at the back end of sets. No penalties on tackle 3, 4, or 5, and fellas, don't rely on the wind to get you home.
Wise words. We've seen that a number of times. We made mention of it in that earlier game, Hannah, didn't we? Wenty 34, Penrith 16. So Penrith out of the comp, even though they finished fifth. And so many points were scored into the breeze, which is a real reflection of attitude as much as anything. Rudolph comes out of the line and nails his man. Oh, it hurt Sammy Williams as well. He's not happy, Sam. He's blowing up at someone anyway. O'Hagan into the breeze. That's a nice kick.
Let's go.
Kennedy, Kennedy. Just about got away from Key. Now, great. Looking to make up for that error. You just get the feeling this is going to be tight all the way to the end. We wouldn't mind seeing them going try for try for the next 35 minutes. Williams. Now to Rudolph. 11 on 11 there. Porter involved in the defensive work for Mounties. Williams again. Trindall is there. Talakai into space. Pushed away from Hingano. And another. Smith Shields couldn't hang on to him. The last tackle. Trindall drifts across field. Rudolph is getting through. Starling read it nicely. Really good play there from both sides.
Yeah, probably not the finish they wanted, the Mounties, but again, the Newtown Jets. But what they need to compress the line here now to give them a penalty away.
Well, that was Satini. He was going to make 20 metres on that charge. Penalty comes the way of Mounties. They might just tap and go. That's what Sammy Williams is thinking. Hands off now to Steve Tavita. Got to make mention of his catch in the in-goal area from the kickoff. It was a beauty. And it was telling us what was said at halftime. Steve did fantastically well. Rennie. Starling. I think we'll see more of this, him running out of dummy half. One's now Boland. To Williams. Short to Porter. He's trying to get some second phase play going. Couldn't do it. To Moko on the outside. Last tackle. They'll go down the short side. There's Williams. Into the corner. Kennedy's got a play at it. Almost a voluntary tackle there from Will. Phillips is going to be shuffled sideways. Oh, I was going to say, I don't think momentum had been stopped throughout the course of that tackle, and there's referee Ultram saying it just got a little high.
Yeah, a bit of an easy piggyback. It was great work by the halfback Sam Williams. Nice little deft little kick to put pressure on Newtown Jets with an easy way out.
Ferris.
That's okay.
He's all over him there, Satini. Lucky he didn't give another penalty away. Vasquez had Rudolph on the outside, decided not to pass.
He's a big hand, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's out of that under 20 side from 2 years ago that John Morris was the coach. They carried all before them and then lost week one, week two of the finals. Mm. Cole Flanagan, Blayke Brailey, this man. Williams was involved in it as well. Will Kennedy was the fullback in that side. Trindall, Talakai, Ngannou, he's putting under pressure as well. Now Trindall is quick, can't get away from the fullback, offloads to Kennedy. That is brilliant, Newtown. They were really clear about who they wanted to target with their runners. They got to their points. The second phase play came, and that is a great team try again for the Jets.
Unbelievable. I love this edge running, number 12, what Siosifa Talakai, he can play, but up through the middle, Braydon Trindall. The pace is everything, but the score, they needed the score next, Jimmy. I think the way the game is changing here, 20 to 14. But great on the edge running, and a great inside ball. Look at this for Talon. Back up through the middle. Under the post, brilliant.
Will Kennedy, son of Bubba Kennedy, just finished his career last year, in fact, age 51. He liked it, team liked it, we liked it. Siosifa Talakai, you mentioned him. He's been in danger out on that right edge the whole day, and he's just trying to get it out of Ngannou every time he carries the football.
He certainly is, Jim. It's just they're lucky they've got two big boppers up front, lane platforms, Toby and big Jolliffe, and just laying a great platform for these guys, which allows him to go water and create his magic.
Trindall here to make it 20 all. It is that. We want a try for try. I think we're going to get that, Hannah.
Jimmy, we are getting try for try in the Canterbury Cup competition, but in the NRL a little bit later today, all on Fox League Super Saturday, it is game time. We're headed to Canberra where the Raiders host the Warriors in their hunt to lock in third position on the ladder so that they can play the Roosters, the defending premiers, in week one of the finals. And then a little bit later in this matchup that also has finals bearing, the Bulldogs host Brisbane. The Doggies have been the banana skin of the competition. Anthony Seibold cannot and will not let this go lightly. And then our final game of Super Saturday on Fox League ends up on the Gold Coast as the Titans and St George have one last go to finish their season strong on a positive note and use that as momentum for 2020.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right with that, Hannah. It's been disappointing seasons, quite obviously, for both the Titans and the Dragons, but they've got to find a positive to take into next year. Football review for the Dragons. Phil Gould involved in that one.
Jimmy, if you can see by that last kickoff, they've got to get better at these kickoffs. That ball nearly went dead. The first one was off the pectoral muscle, but puts them under a bit of pressure.
Well, what about that? Dean Madison, who plays in the halves. He's come on the field. He's a bigger body, but he's one-on-one contact there with Toby Rudolph. Oh, look at this ball run. Look at this ball run. It's a magnificent kick. Absolutely brilliant. And they've got their 40-20. The second for Newtown of this game, and this one more expectedly, with the breeze at their back.
I think it was a 42. That's
right, it was.
Incredible. Certainly kept going rolling, but puts Newtown Jets in a great position, especially in a great tacking position.
Pretty sure it was Braydon Trindall. We'll check that, but that is his second 40-20 of the day. So here we go, Newtown on the attack. Rudolph looking for try number two is held up. Lined up right and left, go right. Trindall's there, dummy. It's going to be hard to stop the car. Pushed away from Murchie, got the try, deserved it. Well, Newtown, now it's their turn to score back-to-back tries.
I've spoken about this guy so often today, Toby Rudolph, laying a great platform, which allows your outside backs to do some, create some havoc. And Trindall, his actual speed is incredible here. The decoy runners were coming through. The outside defenders were saying, who's going to take this man? Quick dummy, pass and go, and he's... That was a great little try, but that was all from a 42, I'll call it. It was a magnificent kick. Put him on the back, put him on the front foot, and a brilliant try to finish off.
Well, you can't do much more for your team there, can you? I mean, you kick the 40-20 or the 42.
We'll call it the 42.
The 42. And then you get the ball, you dummy and score. Next thing you know, they'll ask you to kick the goal. Probably will too, Braydon Trindall. Caboolture Sharks Junior. So he's a Queenslander. Can't hold that against him. Plenty of great Queenslanders have played for the Newtown side.
I hear Trindall. I always think of the old Trindall from South Sydney. Tricky Trindall. So it's got nothing to do with him. Uncle?
Not to my knowledge. Braydon's nickname, though, is Tricky. Here he is, looking to add the extras. The try he set up, the try he scored, the try he converted. Lovely play, Braydon Trindall.
High quality game. Please get the kickoff right here from the Newtown Jets. The sun is in your eyes. Put your hands up, cover the lens, and catch the pill.
I've said it before in the first half after they scored the first try. I'll say it now. They've scored a couple in the row. There you go. Handled the kickoff, no problem. Newtown at their best. Play some really good footy that can trouble all sides. Different stages this year. They're in 11th position, 10th position. Worked their way up the ladder. Finished full of running in the season proper. Three straight victories. Here they go. Ferris, he's a powerhouse. He's got Phillips on the outside. He might not need him. O'Hagan gave him too much space and he's there. Jackson Ferris. We know he's full of power. We didn't know he had pace.
Let's go back to the kickoff, Jimmy. They've finally caught a kickoff. Salah with Vasquez, great hit up. Then Toby Rudolph. But then the outside backs, this kid, the pace, how hard has he run, as you say in commentary? He runs so hard between shoulders, pushing off, and then back his legs.
Yeah, he went straight at Matt Tomoko, and the youngster couldn't quite handle Jackson Ferris. Have a look at it again, front on. Palmerston North Junior, heavily strapped there, thought about a kick, thought about a pass, and then he realised, you know what, I reckon I can take Brendan O'Hagan on the inside. And that's what he did.
Two strong runs before though, Jimmy. Great up front. Good vision to go out wide from, usually they just go up through the middle there, but two great hits through the middle. Wide pass out wide, and then let the speed, let it burn.
Yeah, we saw him a couple of weeks ago at Henson Park. He set up a try for Matty Evans. He was a powerhouse on that occasion, really alerted us to the fact that this guy's a really strong Canterbury Cup player. This will be no problem here for Trindall. Now they've got a bit of a concern here, Mounties. Just a few heads down in the in-goal area. They'll look to their leaders, Bateman, Sam Williams. Here's the kick. They had the extras.
Regards Newtown, just say they do win this game, what's the next path? What direction do they go in?
They will play the loser of the South Sydney Rabbitohs North Sydney Bears clash. That is 2v3 being played at this venue tomorrow.
As we spoke off, like we said, we've seen these guys a couple of weeks ago. I didn't realise how good a side they were. They're certainly getting all their best players back in action, and they'll give it a shake.
Well, a number of players kept out for Mounties down there for that Raiders game against the Warriors. Short kick off, and Gray, shows commitment going in there. I think it did come off the hands of Smith Shields. So that's going to be knock on from Mounties.
Yep.
Put his body on the line there, Aaron Gray. So no Emre Gula today, no Michael Oldfield, no Sebastian Chris. Yeah, definite knock on there from Smith Shields. But it was the reverse for Newtown. They got Blayke Brailey in, who's a recognised dummy half, even though Sorensen does have a bit of history there. They were able to get Jayson Bukuya. These guys are deeply experienced, certainly Bukuya, NRL level, playing International Rugby League as well. Such a bonus for your team. Greg Madison would have appreciated it. Now they get another penalty, so it's Bateman looking to go the one-on-one, and he's had a bit of a chat to referee.
Oh, I love that. See the hand up on the old back chat? The good old days.
It's the little thing sometimes.
I love it. I just remember, if you watch the vision, he puts his hand together like someone was talking. Love it.
A little bit like Hollywood Hartley, really, used to do. Very demonstrative in his refereeing.
As we say, mate, the good old days. Can't beat it.
Elimination final. Mounties up against Newtown. Here's the ball. Rudolph has got it now, and he's got himself one-on-one, and he's done well to hang on there, Sammy Williams, and the much bigger man. Trindall, Vasquez. Made an impact when he's come onto the field, hasn't he?
He has been brilliant, Jimmy. Absolute brilliant.
I knew he would have caught you all right. You like that sort of stuff. Trindall, ball on the inside again, and now it's Rudolph. Second phase play, Brailey. Sorensen will straighten up. Porter does well, shuts him down. Vasquez, another run. Last tackle here for Newtown. Williams is out the back. Brailey will find him. Pushes it on now. Trindall, got to get the ball away. Back to Williams, still the last. He gets the kick away. That's players offside definitely there. Ferris thinks he's not. And now Newtown are going to get themselves a penalty because of the work on Jack Williams after he kicked it.
He's a little bit high, I suppose.
Down there, it's unfortunate I called Held, then you've taken the ball. Down here, he's just got him high, but I don't need him coming at me.
Okay, Luke Bateman, all okay with that. Tom Starling was the man that was coming at him, just having a look at that. Looks like, yeah, it was Daniel Keir.
It was a lazy hit, wasn't it? It wasn't really a hit, it was just a pull down, but around the neck.
Well, it's significant because this is now going to allow Newtown to push their lead out past that two converted tries. Yeah. So now they've got to score three times, Mounties.
They've got 20 minutes to go. It's just the situation's probably good for the Newtown Jets to suck in the big ones now. Nice little be 2 points here straight between the posts. They've certainly rebounded magnificent from the start of the game when they dropped the ball from the kickoff, received the try, but they've been outstanding since then.
That is the kick from Trindall. Oh, he snuck it in.
Oh, just.
He snuck it in, but he got it. He's not really happy with himself, but don't worry, Braydon. They're all worth 2 points.
Yeah, the energy seems to have gone out of the Mounties a little bit. You just see the shoulders are down. They've got to be the next scorer. Simple as that. They're what, 14 points now. Two tries. We said 20 points at half time with this wind. They're going to go for the short kickoff again. Oh, that's horrible.
Well, they might get the bounce. They don't get the bounce. Didn't break the plane. And that is a penalty in the middle of halfway. Last thing they needed. Got to remember, as you say, there's still 20 minutes remaining. Yeah. Prepared to work your way into the game.
Yeah, they didn't need that, did they, Jimmy, after giving away the 2 points, they needed to be, at least try and get the ball back, but get another penalty.
Got a hold for it, Anna. Wait! Go!
And a massive set of 6 MD.
Oh! Ngannou and Gray came together, heavy contact. Rudolph. This time it was Vasquez supporting him, decided not to use him. Nice quick play of the ball though. Trindall. Teig Wilton's on the field now, Naruma Devils Jr. Still going after contact there. Left side, Vasquez, I thought, really nice hands, but it wasn't, knocked it on. Just put him under a little bit of pressure there, Blayke Brailey.
Yeah, it wasn't the best of passes, was it? I think in relation to the player, it's hitting the ball. I probably should have got it a little bit deeper. No, I don't think it was a bad pass. I'll blame the blame the dummy half for that one. As a front row, you don't want to be copping those sort of balls at pace. Stay close to the line and a hitch in the knee.
Here's the Newtown bench. Underneath all of that, I believe, is Coach Greg Madison. There we go. Loves the publicity, Greg.
He looks cold down there. I'm worried about Hannah down there. She's about to blow off.
I'm not kidding when I say this. I've been watching the empty bench chairs slowly move their way by the wind. They're getting blown over.
I reckon by the time the game ends, you'll be down to the corner post.
Here they go, Mounties. Hingano. Murchill straighten up. Can offload with Talakai over the top. Been coach of Newtown since 2008, Greg Madison. Won the competition back in 2012, of course. They went so close last year. Nice late offload. Starling it is now. Got the runner through the middle. That's Keir. Lovely ball.
Good picked pick up
on the fly by O'Hagan. And they get the penalty. This is better work from them. Starling ready to go. Ooh. The timing from the trainer from Newtown. Kennedy, it is with what may very well be a legitimate... Oh, I think it is. It's a bit of blood coming from the nose. Oh, friendly fire over the top there from your man, Toby Rudolph.
I told you it was hard, man. He liked to, he'd take anyone out. He took out his mate. Yeah, on the beak. The ice start windproofing, don't they? The water comes through, but that's part of life now. You've got to stop in play. When a play goes down injured, sometimes I think they play it a bit harder. Sometimes you think if the shoelace is coming down, they stop the play, but you can see by this reaction, these young kids copping in the beak.
Well, we've got to be so careful with head injuries these days. Yeah. You saw on Thursday night with that Rabbitohs versus Roosters game, it took an age to finish that second half, didn't it?
Wasn't it brutal? Oh, head collisions after head collisions, and I don't know how many stitches were inserted that evening.
Well, I think we might have the mummy here for Will Kennedy. As Daniel Vasquez leaves the field, stick around, of course, league fans, because we've got a really good game coming up. It's the Raiders up against the Warriors. Yeah, the Raiders will be strong favourites for it, but they need to win to get into that third spot to make sure that they play the Roosters in first week of the semi-finals. They want to continue the winning form. They want to make sure that they're getting combinations right. You wonder who they're going to rest. All that coming up as your Super Saturday continues here on Fox League.
You wonder who invented, what do you call it, the mummy there? This
the mummy.
Poor bugger. How's he breathe?
Remember
Michael, the old days
Michael
when
Vella had it when...
Michael Vella was he had it one gun up and over.
I think Johnny Carlaw was the first, the former. He had it when he was at the Warriors. It's not the most flattering of taping, anyway. Mounties, not desperate that they score. It'll be very handy, though. Key with the carry. Starling to Williams. Hingano ball on the inside. Satini's a strong carrier. And he releases. Addo was getting ready for the next play. Toby Rudolph, was it? Oh, what an opportunity. And don't tell me Addo Hingano's hurt his shoulder again.
What a play by Rudolph. Seriously, the tackling defence, but they got the loose carry. They're game changers.
We've got a Mounties player down in the back play, and that looks like a concussion injury. Playing on, it's Luke Bateman, tough as an old pair of boots. The Miles Devils Jr. gets his way back into the defensive line. I just hope Addo Hingano hasn't done that shoulder again. It's so much time out. Wilton goes through, Williams on the outside, passes early, doesn't matter. Williams dives over the 10-metre line. Have you ever seen anything like it? Sorensen throws to Trindall. I can't believe that. Here's the mummy. Kennedy. He wants to offload. He doesn't. Last tackle. Spud, he dived over the 10-metre line.
he thought that was a try line. That was incredible. Oh, my God, what a great break. But that was one of the funniest things. Mate, the poster an extra 10 metres further, mate.
Here's the run from Wilton. It's a beauty.
What's
nice
this?
Footwork and the offload. Jack Williams, players in support, scores it.
It was a try in his eyes anyway.
Or did he know? Did he? Was he just going to ground?
It's great commentary anyway.
Can we give him the benefit of the doubt? Dear me.
The brilliant by Wilton. Great in-between shoulders. Great go forward.
I'm sure this would have been a part of Greg Madison's tip sheet. Tom Starling out of dummy half. You mentioned pre-game just how many carries he's had there. He's just starting to come into his own now. There's a bit of fatigue around. It's when he's at his most dangerous. Oh, ball out in front of Williams. He's O'Hagan. Just a little cramped up. Williams came up with the tackle, so he had 6-on-6. This is Sam Williams under pressure. He's going to kick it again, and he'll kick again. There's space in behind there, too. Will Kennedy back to get it and offloads. Nice work. Katoa has speed.
They're probably the best two chip and chases I've seen in a row.
Now Phillips. Handled by Royce Hunt, who's back out onto the field. Katoa with another carry. Tomoko. Trying to hang on. Offloads to Brailey. Nice hands. He wants Jolliffe to go forward. He does that. So he's back out onto the field as well. Here's Wilton again. Lovely footwork. It's the second time we've seen that from Teig. Sorensen. Last tackle. Williams. And he's just going to run the clock down. Nice control of this game, leading by 14. And now you're getting to the point they need, what is it, more than a point a minute.
Yeah, great end of the set there. Gives the forwards a bit of a breather. As I've been talking very highly about Toby Rudolph, made 14 carries for 140 metres coming off the bench. Not a bad earn, is it, for him?
Gee, that's interesting. Sam Williams coming from the field, interchange number 8. Doesn't look like he's injured. And Sorensen down again. Just look, he's got a little bit of a limp there too. We made mention of that ankle injury that we saw a couple of games ago. Let's
go. What's your take on Newtown, Jimmy, regards how deep you reckon they can go, mate? Do you reckon they can give this title a shake? We've seen every game this year.
Well, as we mentioned, they play the loser of the South Sydney Rabbitohs and the North Sydney Bears, and both those sides have shown real consistency this year. May not have the stars of some of the other sides, but what their respective coaches, Shane Millard and Jason Taylor, have been able to do with them has been fantastic. But this is the pointy end of the season. And what we've seen from Newtown here today has been highly impressive.
Yeah, very. As we talk about, it's the time of year you want to play rugby league, and whoever turns up on the day, you can win the game.
So Mounties, Starling. More running out of dummy half. Long ball, lovely ball, better tackle. Aaron Gray it was. Shut down Ruben Rennie. Starling, the last. Ooh, it's floater in the air there for Kennedy. And he's away. Still haven't seen Will Kennedy in some open space. Such an athlete, he just glides along the turf.
His evasion skills is quite incredible to see live, isn't it?
76 tackle breaks for the year for Will Kennedy, fourth in the league. Averages over 100 metres a game. Lolo back on the field. Brailey taking the advantage of the one marker to Lolo.
So there's the last. Where's the control of Williams? Instead, they go right to Trindall. This is a test. O'Hagan's going to let it bounce, and the wind takes it over the back. That's not the kick Braydon Trindall and Newtown were looking for there.
That's where he needed the pitching iron. Bit of a backspin, but unfortunately hit and rolled. Seven tackle set, not ideal. 11 minutes to go.
Siosifa Talakai coming off. He's had another outstanding day. Proved a threat out on that right-hand side at every opportunity.
I think he's been a standout, Jimmy. Has he done much first grade? Has he played first grade? Why isn't he playing first grade? He seems to have everything.
Played NRL games with the South Sydney Rabbitohs back in 2016 and 17.
When you see players come up here, mate, I feel like they're too good for this league. And I guarantee you, he is one of those. Good hit.
Here's Rudolph on Rennie. Madison, long ball to O'Hagan, who really didn't have any other option but the kick. Kennedy is patient and gets away from O'Hagan. Can't get in the field of play. Nice work there from Tomoko. So this will be an opportunity for Mounties. We've got an injury update for Mounties. Let's get down to Hannah.
Thank you, Jimmy. I'm just speaking to the Mounties bench now. Daniel Keir, he's done his AC joint on his left shoulder. He's done for the day. He could return if absolutely needed, but I doubt we'll see him again. And I checked on Sam Williams. Agree, I thought it was interesting. He came from the field. It's his left groin. He strained it. It also happened last week. He also wasn't able to finish out last week's game. Now, we imagine the Mounties, they will be out after today. Their season is over. So I wonder what happens if perhaps Sam Williams is required for NRL duty during the final series.
Very good point, Hannah. You would think he's been a cover for Hayden Caesar, Jack Whiten at different stages. As we mentioned, huge experience at NRL level. Time with the Raiders and the Dragons and Catalan and Wakefield. Now back and playing with the Raiders / Mounties. So they need something here. It's getting to desperation stakes for Mounties. Porter. Last time we saw Dean Madison in action was against the Knights. He was, we thought, best player on the ground.
Yeah.
It's his chance to take control of this side, get the penalty. Here they go. This is Madison. Ngannou, to see recovered from that shoulder injury. Not quite getting their structures right there. Happened a couple of times to them. Just wonder how many times these teams get to train together. Porter. Certainly the personnel change with some in Sydney and some down at Canberra. Starling, it's a long ball to Ngannou. Murchie is there. Murchie is grabbing across field. Trindle's there hanging on. Does well. Some help from Wilton. There you go, not getting to his feet, but they were saying defenders all over him. Hard to disagree with that one. Here's the tap from Rennie. It's going to be under the stop. They're pushing him sideways. Again, Trindle. I mean, tigerish in defence. Gano, Rennie. Must score this set of six. Starling out of dummy half. Defence is there. They shut him down. Ngannou, long ball. Madison goes out the back. Oh, look at the strength of the breeze. That's now backwards 20 metres. Satini can't hang on to it. Tomoko's there. They're beyond halfway. And he's picked off by Ferris. Wow, that breeze is strong. He missed it by a metre, Madison. And the side's under all sorts of pressure. O'Hagan was the only one behind the footy on that occasion. Madison, they're going to chance their arm again. Ngannou, that's last tackle. Not sure he knew.
I think they probably thought it was a six again, but that was the world's longest set of six. As you said, Jimmy, the wind's that ball went back 30 metres.
There you go, the Newtown chant goes up. The Jets faithful are here in good numbers. From what I understand, roughly about 8,972, Spud.
Beautiful. Who gave you that?
That's the crowd. Leachy.
Oh, yeah.
Sorensen. Now he's got Ferris on the outside. Finds him. They'll get a try. Lovely work from Scott Sorensen. And that's a little cherry on top for not only Jackson Ferris, but the Newtown Jets.
Incredible. That's Sorensen. 200 metres he made last week. I guarantee he's going to get close to back and lapping in this week. His form has been outstanding. I think the Bailey back here playing hooker has allowed him to go out wide through the gaps. And a great pass here, Jackson Ferris. That's a really good win by the Newtown Jets. As I said, I'm a high fan of the way they play. Their forward structure is brilliant. They've got some outstanding backs who can certainly score tries. And as we said, we're in semi-final, mate. Anyone can win this comp.
Yeah,
as long as you want to, as long as you want to aim up.
Sorry, mate. Brailey does make a difference, doesn't he? You know, they don't lose much with Rudolph if he's starting on that edge. But Sorensen is NRL class, and
yes,
just showed it on that occasion. Brayley's NRL class as well.
It shows you. Yeah, you've got to have a. They call it the spine these days, Jimmy. But you know, this young kid. But Brailey, he's certainly the talent he's learnt down at the Sharks, certainly come over here on the for the Newtown Jets. I reckon I think I need someone to hold this ball here. Old school. He'll probably fall over again. Hurry up.
No time taken. Oh, look at that. That's what you call the big in-swinger there.
Inside out.
You do with him at Old Trafford.
That's how I play golf. The old slice, but it certainly got through the post.
40-20. There you go.
I know it's a high scoring game, but it hasn't been a great game. It's been to and fro in the first half. In the first half, there's only 4 points difference. And now with the Newtown Jets, certainly with a win behind them, 20 points. Told it was worth 20 points.
You got to remember that Mounties had it as well, too. You know,
so. Yeah, but I said they'll win by 20. You got to win by 20.
16 points to 4. Mounties led at one stage.
Yeah, I know. Unbelievable.
So they scored 3 tries in a row with the Breeze in that first half. And unfortunately, that was about it. Tomoko been named in the junior Kiwi side. Nice footwork that he showed there. I imagine he's still eligible for under-20s competition next year. Mm. Starling. Madison lost runners. Thought he had another one out the back there. So here's Hingano trying to organise his play. Gets the ball. Players on the outside. Ball inside Murchie. Yeah, it is nice defence. Rudolph it was shutting down O'Hagan. Last tackle. Rennie went short.
Well done.
Oh, put his man under a lot of pressure. Here's Rudolph.
Best thing about that set of 6, Jimmy, was that they wanted to go in at full-time. No more scores. Well, in the last 3 minutes, to hold the line like that was outstanding. And getting the loose ball should be highly commended.
You talked about the quality of the game. Both sides completing at 83%.
Wow.
Anything over 80 is exceptional.
Incredible.
Vasquez. He's made an impression today, hasn't he, Spud?
Yeah, it's the first game I've seen him play live, but I tell you what, this kid, he can play.
Sorensen gets around O'Hagan, can't get away from Tomoko. Another great run from the back rower. Lolo to Williams, back on the inside. Here's Trindall. No real option for him on that occasion. Luke Polselli's on the field. Brailey goes away from him to Lolo. Thought about the second phase play, and Vasquez was, in his mind, over under the post. Here he comes down to Williams. There's Polselli, offloads, no one there. Dummy, Wilton's got good footwork, he'll put it down, he'll score a try. Really getting away from Mounties now. They'll enjoy that, Newtown. This has been a complete domination in the second half. And they are through to the next week in the semi-finals of the Canterbury Cup, New South Wales.
Yeah, as you said, Jimmy, they were down 16-14 and then come back. Just showed great resilience and to score a great try. This kid deserves a try. He's had an outstanding game. Wilton picked up loose ball, right foot, left foot step, and great way to finish.
Came on the back of another break from Scott Sorensen. So Wilton's doing a job out in the left centre position. He's only slight. He can play edge, back row. He plays in the middle as well. And he was going to be too hard to stop from there.
You talk about stats, Jimmy. Scott Sorensen, I'll just go through him here. 14 carries, 214 metres,
wow.
23 tackles. I call him the full package. Mate, he doesn't stop. Over 200 metres, but as you said, mate, we've got a really, really highly classed hooker in Blayke Brailey, which allows him to get wide of the ruck. And as you can see, he's some of his runs have been 30 metres.
Keep going. Six tackle breaks, one offload, two line break assists, and just the three try assists for the back row.
Surely he's going to be man of the match.
Well, we'll have to wait and see.
Right post, give it some.
Hannah's decision. Trindall.
Come back.
He's hit it. No, he's hit it too well. That went gun barrel straight.
It's a really, I've had an outstanding afternoon watching these two highly talented teams. But as I say, the cream always rises to the top. The Newtown Jets, first time I've seen them play a couple of weeks ago, stood out for me. And they are my pick to give this comp certainly a rattle. And the big end, the big hot top enders, look out.
All right, so you reckon the team that finished seventh, ball on the ground, Newtown come up with it. The team that finished seventh is going to challenge for the competition.
Yeah, I do. I've seen some today. They're down 16-4 into a crazy wind. And they're caught up at halftime and certainly put it back into what they want to do in the second half.
More than caught up. They certainly went past Mounties, didn't they? In the end, a convincing victory for the boys from Newtown. 44 points to 20, Newtown over Mounties. Really enjoyable game of footy. Some good skill on offer and some standout players. Well, mostly in the Newtown side, Spud.
Yeah, it certainly was, Jimmy. I'm also going to go for the forwards. I think Jolliffe was magnificent, but my man was... Toby Rudolph, I think, for like I said, he's come back from his ACL injuries. The try score, left foot, right foot step to get on near the post. The smile on his face when he scored the try. But his defence today has been unbelievable, mate. Like he's been outstanding. 15 carries, 151 metres, 24 tackles for a big man.
Yeah, been excellent. Remember, tomorrow the semi-final series continues. We'll have the qualifying finals. It's St George Illawarra up against Canterbury, South Sydney up against North Sydney, and the loser of that game, South Sydney and North Sydney, will take on the Newtown Jets. The way it plays out, just a reminder too, if you're tuning in to get ready for your Super Saturday of NRL footy, we've got the Raiders and the Warriors up next. Marty Tapau, grade 3, careless high tackle, early guilty plea 1 week. Kane Evans, grade 2, careless high tackle, early guilty plea 1 week. Has implications for those sides that are going into the first week of the semi-finals. Let's get down onto the ground because Hannah is there with the person we think was the best on the ground.
Thank you, Jimmy. Scott Sorensen, congratulations on such a convincing win. You live to fight another day as your hope of playing finals continues. Now, during that match, the Jets always seemed to be in touch with Mounties, but in the second half, you just ran away with it. What was the difference?
I think it was, we just had to play the conditions today. Okay. The wind was real strong, so we took that into consideration in the first half, that we just had to sort of roll our sleeves up and work hard, and that'll help us in the second half, and I guess it did.
You had a game-high run metres, 214, in fact. Why? What was it about today's game that brought out one of your best performances?
Oh, just I don't know. I just think I'm really enjoying my footy with Newtown, and I'm really enjoying playing with all the boys that I play week in, week out with. So I think I just really enjoy my footy at the moment.
Well, we have to wait until tomorrow to see who you will be playing next week, but it'll be out of South Sydney and North Sydney. Do you have a preference of either of those teams?
Not really, to be honest. Just whoever we get, we get. So, no, we're looking forward to it. We'll rest up and look forward to next weekend.
Well, good luck.
Cheers. Thank you. Ta.
It was spectacular, wasn't it?